Hello everyone, thank you for tuning into Rusty Science. This is a continuation of our previous episode, Can We See Live Dinosaurs in 21st Century? If you haven't watched it, I highly recommend you to watch that video before continuing this. The card is there here. In case if you're not, I'll summarize you quickly. Okay, basic building block of our vision, our light, is called photon. This photon can travel in straight line around 300,000 kilometers per second in straight line. The amount of distance the photon can travel in light speed for a whole year is called one light year. In that case, the photons bounce back from the dinosaurs, which lived 250 million years ago, could have reached 250 million light years. Coincidentally, there is a galaxy called Frankenstein galaxy, which is approximately 250 million light years away. In case somebody from Frankenstein galaxy right now, if they look towards our Earth, they would probably collect that photon in their telescope, and they should probably see dinosaurs walking around this Earth quite calmly. But our important question is how we can get there in order to see those live dinosaurs walking in this Earth. How we can get to a place where even gravity undefined light took 250 million years to reach in a short span of our lifetime? That's the biggest question we should answer right now. If you know Einstein's special theory of relativity, you may not get confused with this conundrum, because there he clearly explained the wonderful relationship between speed and time. He stated that whenever an object started moving, it experiences time slowly than an object at rest. What? This is a crazy question, right? How a two person who is on the same space can experience time differently? That's the same question people had at the time when he publishes his paper. But that is called time dilation. Okay? I will explain it in a simple manner. If you travel in a car around 100 kilometers per hour, then you would probably experience time 9.25 into 10 to the power of 9 seconds slower than a person who is standing beside the road. Compared to the speed of light, our vehicle speed is too slow, so we are not able to experience the time dilation that much easily. But if you keep increasing the speed, then the rate of change of time will be very quite significant that even a normal people can feel. I will give you one example. There is a distant star which is called Ross 154, which is approximately 9.68 light years away. If I can travel in the speed of 90% the speed of light, then obviously it will take 11 years for me to reach to that particular star. But for an observer, it would take 11 years, but for the person who is journeying to, for him, it would take only 4 years, 7 months to reach. That is called time dilation. A same scenario, two people experiences time differently, because time is not absolute, it's relative. It is quite common that two people, one is moving, another is stationary, is quite often disagree with the rate of change of time. I would give you one easy example. Our International Space Station, which is circling around our Earth, experiences time dilation. It may be surprising to hear, but every once in 6 months, our scientists change their clock 7 milliseconds up, because the International Space Station experiences 7 milliseconds slower than the people, those who are living on this Earth. Now let's come back to our Frankenstein galaxy theory, okay? The Frankenstein galaxy is 250 million light years far away from us. Think about it. If I can travel the big number, like 99.149% the speed of the light, then for a viewer, it would take around 250 million years to reach there. But for a traveler, it would hardly take 4.5 years to get there. It looks crazy, right? But it's in our lifetime, obviously, we should be able to reach the Frankenstein galaxy if we just travel in that particular speed. But it does not seem right, because though due to the time dilation, the traveler think he only traveled 4 years, 7 months or 4.5 years, actually it took 250 million years for him to reach. In that case, obviously, the dinosaur era might have long gone. right? So we should have some sort of alternate way to get in there. Okay, let's think about it in this way. This is like 99.9999999% of the speed of the light. What if we can travel faster than the speed of light? Then obviously we should be able to overtake the photons, the past photons which hit us and just going forward, right? Then we should be able to overtake our past events and we should be able to go forward, and once you reach certain position, just turn back and see the photons, your past events you should be able to see, right? If you ever watched DC Comics Flash series, then you may be familiar with it. Whenever Flash travels back in time, he will go through the speed force where obviously he sees the previous events as like a photo frames or videos, which is nothing but the photons which is traveling, but he overtakes those photons and moving forward and he will reach the past. If a person who can travel 250 million times faster than the speed of light, then I would say he would possibly reach to the distance far, far away galaxy, which is called Frankenstein galaxy, in less than a year. Again, if you consider the time dilation, maybe for the observers it may be look like 1 year, but for him it may be look like a fraction of seconds or maybe less than that. Some of the hypotheses mention that he will go into past, but still, whatever be the ways, he should be probably able to reach in his lifespan, and in the same way, without missing the past photons, he should be able to reach Frankenstein galaxy in fraction of seconds. Let's see how this overtaking the past takes place with this small example. Okay, in this example, light from the source hit on the object and travel in the straight line, as we have seen in the previous example. But if a person can travel twice the speed of light, he will overtake the photon and eventually he will see the events once again. That means the past events. See this counter, it shows number 2. Space traveler also will see the same number, which is 2, but he cannot see number 1 because it has gone last second, because last second itself 1 is gone. Now the next second, counter will become 3. Person A, who is standing here, will see number 2, but you will see the past event, which is number 1. Since you traveled twice the speed of light, you already overtook your past event and you have reached 1. This phenomena will push you further into past. If you keep increasing the speed, then the speed of light, then eventually you will reach your past. It looks very amazing, right? It looks like that's it. But all the scientific hypotheses will have a catch. The catch is, as per the special theory of relativity, Einstein stated that the speed of light is constant. Anything with a mass cannot reach the speed of light. To reach the speed of light, you should be a massless substance like photon. If you are not able to reach the speed of light, then how can we go faster than the speed of light? This is a problem for today, but we never know when physics come up with a new theory or hypothesis to prove that we can move faster than the speed of light. In that case, it may not be a big deal. Apart from that, we have a few other problems, which are finding such a huge powerful telescope to view from Frankenstein galaxy to Earth. And again, the photons collection is a very big problem, because we may not know how much photons might have reached Frankenstein galaxy without hitting or colliding with the space objects. And how to find such a powerful boosters to thrust our spacecraft so fast that 250 million times faster than the speed of light, it may look a little problematic. Apart from that, the g-force the body experiences, our body cannot sustain more than 5g of acceleration. If we just go beyond the speed of light, you may be explode somewhere in the meanwhile. Apart from that, finally, maybe I would say the space debris. Okay, there are minute particles. If we are going in the speed of light, it can cause a major impact on our spacecraft. If we can overcome all these factors, then space journey is very easy and we should able to easily reach Frankenstein galaxy and see our dinosaurs. But let's come to the final conclusion. Is it possible to see live dinosaurs in 21st century? The answer is, with our current technology and understanding of physics, it's not possible. But we never know. Whenever the new invention comes, we need to have a keen eye on it. Maybe it can open a door for us to see the dinosaurs. But some of the sci-fi movies which shows like time travel, wormhole, black hole, all those things, how does that things work? We will discuss more in our blog post as well as in the future video. Stay tuned. I will meet you with one more interesting topic in the coming weeks.